Can one of you lovely boys take us back to Naseby?
No problem, Miss Greeley, said a blushing young police officer. I'll just clear it with the governor, and I can have you there in 10 minutes.
Thank you. You coming, Troy?
Savage dropped the binoculars, and his face looked pale and drawn.
What?
Said Greeley, concerned.
I just saw who they've arrested, said Savage.
A police van and several cars had now arrived by the canal side, and the prisoners had been located. As she was helped to her feet, Miss Tradescant saw the kidnapper in handcuffs and began whimpering. It was the first noise that she had made in hours. A police officer worked at untying Esme Handybode's and Andrew Tremens's bonds.
"Are you all unharmed?" asked Christie.
"Yes, I think so," said Tremens. "What a nightmare that was."
"These officers will take you back to the incident room, where we'll take your statements, if you're up to it, that is," he said.
"I am," said Mrs. Handybode. "I'm not sure I can say the same for Brenda, though."
Brenda Tradescant had dropped to the ground once again and had curled herself into a ball. She was wailing like a fire siren. Frank Shunter watched as the suspect was loaded into the police van.
"Like peas in a pod," he said.
Chapter 28. Blunt emerged from his car and waved to the handful of crab fans that were still lingering around outside Naseby Village Hall.
"I've caught the murderer," he said simply. "Press conference here in 10 minutes. Spread the word."
The Millies ran away in excitement to tell everyone they knew. It was 7:30 p.m. and the doors had opened at the Masonic Hall for the evening's all-star performance of Evil Company Corrupts.